So students, our today's topic is application of distribution law in the process of extraction. So first of all, I'm coming to extraction. What is the meaning of extraction? For this, I will give you a simple example. You already know, all of you know that we are having sugar in our houses. Now sugar is soluble in water. Suppose I am having sugar dissolved in water. Now if I ask you that you have to separate the sugar from water, then it is little bit difficult to get crystals of sugar from water or to separate sugar from water. So for separating sugar from water, what I will do, I will take an organic solvent in which sugar is more soluble as compared to that in water. Then what I will do, I will shake this solution or aqueous solution of sugar with organic solvent. Now what will happen? If the sugar is more soluble in organic solvent, then the sugar will pass from water to the organic solvent. Now all this procedure is done in separating funnel. After shaking the two layers, we just keep the separating funnel for some time so that two layers separate out. Then by using separating funnel, you can easily separate the two layers. Now as the two layers are separate, we are having most of the sugar in organic layer. Now as organic solvents, most of the organic solvents are volatile or they can be easily evaporated. So if the solution of sugar in organic solvent is there and we evaporate it, then we can easily evaporate this solution at lower temperature as compared to the boiling point of water. So we can easily separate sugar from aqueous solution by using the process of extraction. Now what is the meaning of this extraction? Humne kya kiya ki humne sugar ko solution mein se kisi dusre solvent ya organic solvent jise hum kahenge extracting solvent ka use karke separate kar liya. Is process ko hum bolte hain extraction. So this is you can see on the screen. What is the definition of extraction? Extraction refers to the process of separation of a substance from a mixture solution. And for the process of extraction, what we need? We need a solvent, which is generally called extracting solvent. Is that clear? Now what is the extraction? Process of separation of a substance from a mixture solution is known as extraction, and usually this solution is in the form of liquid. Now in order to carry out extraction efficiently, there are certain conditions. So you can see in the red I have mentioned conditions for the process of extraction to be more efficient. So first condition for the process of extraction to be more efficient is that the partition coefficient of the substance between the extracting solvent and the solvent in which it is already dissolved should be high. I have marked this line. I have selected this line. You can see what I have written. For the process of extraction to be efficient, the partition coefficient of the substance between the extracting solvent and the solvent in which it is already dissolved should be high in favor of the extracting solvent. What is the meaning of this line? Iska matlab hai ki jis substance se hum extract kar rahe hain, jis solvent ka use karke hum extract kar rahe hain substance ko aur jisme wo ghula hai, to un dono mein जो पार्टीशन कोफिशियंट है एक्सट्रैक्टिंग सॉल्वेंट के फेवर में हाई होना चाहिए, मतलब उसकी सॉल्युबिलिटी एक्सट्रैक्टिंग सॉल्वेंट में ज़्यादा होनी चाहिए एज कम्पेयर टू दैट इन द सॉल्वेंट इन विच इट इज डिजॉल्व, देन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्शन वुड बी एफिशिएंट. इज इट क्लियर? नाउ द सेकंड कंडीशन इज दैट द सॉल्वेंट एट डिस्पोजल शुड बी यूज इन लार्ज नंबर ऑफ इंस्टॉलमेंट्स और लॉट्स rather than using in single installment. You can see this, I have selected this. The solvent at disposal, that is the extracting solvent, should be used in large number of installments or lots rather than using in single installment. Now iska kya matlab hai ki hamare paas jo jitna bhi solvent hai वो एक बार में यूज़ नहीं किया जाना चाहिए, वो एक से ज़्यादा बार में यूज़ किया जाना चाहिए. अब अगर किसी चीज़ को मैं एक से ज़्यादा बार में यूज़ करूँगा तो मैं कहूँगा कि मैंने उसे मल्टी स्टेप्स में यूज़ किया. सो दिस प्रोसेस इज़ नोन एज मल्टी स्टेप एक्सट्रैक्शन. यू कैन सी दिस ऑन द स्क्रीन, आई हैव मार्क दिस. दिस इज़ नोन एज मल्टी स्टेप एक्सट्रैक्शन. नाउ व्हाट इज़ मल्टी स्टेप एक्सट्रैक्शन? मल्टी स्टेप एक्सट्रैक्शन, कमिंग टू this, I am highlighting the part which I am explaining. Here I have given the meaning of multi-step extraction. Multi-step extraction का मतलब है कि जब हमारे पास extracting solvent पड़ा है कुछ quantity में, volume में, तो हम उसे एक step में या एक install में या एक lot में use ना करके एक से ज़्यादा installments या lots में use करेंगे, तो उसे हम बोलेंगे multi-step extraction. So what is multi-step extraction? Multi-step extraction is a extraction in which we use extracting solvent in more than one installment rather than using in single installment. Is it clear? So that is known as multi-step extraction. So what we did till now in the process of extraction, we studied the definition of extraction and we discussed the conditions for the process of extraction to be efficient. So what are the two conditions for the process of extraction to be efficient? First condition is that the partition coefficient of the solute should be high in favor of the extracting solvent. Is it clear? Or I can simply say that partition coefficient of the solute in organic solvent to that in aqueous phase should be high. Secondly, the solvent at disposal should be used in large number of lots rather than using in single installment. Now what is the use of this? Or now here one question arises, that how will you prove that multi-step extraction is better as compared to single-step extraction? A question usually comes here, that how will you prove that a multi-step extraction is better as compared to single-step extraction? So for this we will take an example. Let we are having a solute. I am selecting the part which I am explaining so that it becomes easier for you to focus. Let we are having capital A grams of solute dissolved in 1 liter of water, and we are having 1 liter of ether, or I can say 1000 ml of ether as extracting solvent with us. Now, assuming the partition coefficient of the substance A to be 2, हम ये मान के चल रहे हैं कि जो सब्सटांस जिसे हमने एक्सट्रैक्ट करना है उसका पार्टीशन कोफिशियंट ईथर और वाटर में 2 है, मतलब ईथर में वो 2 टाइम्स ज़्यादा सॉल्युबल है एज कम्पेयर टू दैट इन वाटर, एंड वी वॉन्ट टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द सब्सटांस A फ्रॉम ईथर इन टू from water into
ईथर.
नाउ वी कैन डू दिस इन टू डिफरेंट वेज. हाउ? वी आर हैविंग 1000 ml ऑफ ईथर. नाउ फर्स्ट केस इज दैट वी कैन यूज होल ऑफ द ईथर इन सिंगल इंस्टॉलमेंट ऑफ 1000 ml. फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज व्हाट? दैट वी यूज 1000 ml ऑफ ईथर फॉर एक्सट्रैक्टिंग सब्सटेंस ए फ्रॉम एक्वस लेयर इन सिंगल इंस्टॉलमेंट. मतलब हम एक ही बार में 1000 ml ईथर के डाल देंगे एक्वस सॉल्यूशन में. और दूसरा केस क्या है कि मैं 1000 ml ईथर इकट्ठे ना डाल के 500 ml दो बार में डाल दूं. ऐसा भी हो सकता है. या फिर ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि मैं 250 ml की इंस्टॉलमेंट्स में 4 times डाल दूं. ऐसा भी हो सकता है. या फिर ऐसा भी कर सकते हैं कि हम 125 ml के इंस्टॉलमेंट्स 8 times डाल दूं. सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इन स्पाइट ऑफ यूजिंग ईथर इन सिंगल इंस्टॉलमेंट आई एम यूजिंग दैम इन लार्ज नंबर ऑफ इंस्टॉलमेंट्स. एंड इट इज अप टू यू दैट इन हाउ मैनी इंस्टॉलमेंट्स यू वॉन्ट टू यूज द ईथर. इज इट क्लियर? सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन दिस वी आर हैविंग टू केसेस. फर्स्ट केस इज, व्हाट इज फर्स्ट केस? आई हैव शोन दिस इन रेड एंड बोल्ड. केस वन, इफ वी यूज ईथर इन वन इंस्टॉलमेंट. एंड सेकेंड केस इज इफ वी यूज ईथर इन, दिस इज द सेकेंड केस, इफ वी यूज ईथर इन टू इंस्टॉलमेंट्स ऑफ 500 ml ईच. दिस इज द सेकेंड केस. और यू कैन हैव दिस एज इफ यूज ईथर इन लार्ज नंबर ऑफ इंस्टॉलमेंट्स. That is up to you that in how much ml you want to use. Is it clear? So I am coming back to the first case, that is if we use ether in one installment. This is the first case. I'm highlighting it. So if I am using first case, that is I am using ether in one installment of 1000 ml. So let small x grams of the solute are extracted from ether in, from water into ether using single installment of 1000 ml. मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ कि हमारे पास पानी में जो सॉल्यूट घुला है उसको एक्सट्रैक्ट करने के लिए मैंने ईथर एक ही बार में 1000 ml डाल दिया. अब जब हमने उसे ईथर 1000 ml के साथ शेक किया, देन व्हाट विल हैपन? The substance will go from aqueous layer into the ether layer. Now, if initially I was having capital A grams of the solute in aqueous layer and x grams of the solute are extracted from aqueous layer or water into the ether, then I can say that some amount of the substance will be left unextracted in the aqueous layer. And how much will be that amount? That will be equal to amount initially present minus amount that goes into the ether layer. So this will come out to be equal to A minus X. You can see I am highlighting it. The amount of substance left unextracted in aqueous layer will be given by A minus X grams. ये कौन सा अमाउंट है? ये वो अमाउंट है जो एक्सट्रैक्शन के बाद पानी में बच गया. इज इट क्लियर? सो आई कैन से द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूट इन ईथर विल बी इक्वल टू, अब ईथर में हमारे पास आ गए एक्स ग्राम्स और ईथर कितना लिया था हमने 1000 ml. सो आई कैन से दैट कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सॉल्यूट इन ईथर विल बी इक्वल टू एक्स अपॉन 1000. एंड सिमिलरली द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूट इन द ईथर विल बी इक्वल टू A minus X upon 1000. How? Because when extraction is complete by using 1000 ml, so amount left in the water will be equal to A minus X. So water we are having 1000 ml, so concentration of water, so concentration of solute in water will be equal to A minus X divided by 1000. But वी नो दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लॉ द पार्टीशन कोफिशियंट इज गिवन बाय रेशियो ऑफ द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सॉल्यूट इन ऑर्गेनिक लेयर टू दैट इन एक्वस लेयर. सो आई कैन राइट हेयर दैट सी ईथर अपॉन सी वॉटर इज इक्वल टू के. दिस इज आई एम हाईलाइटिंग इट. वॉट इज पार्टीशन कोफिशियंट? रेशियो ऑफ द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सॉल्यूट इन ईथर अपॉन रेशियो ऑफ द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूट इन वॉटर. दिस इज द पार्टीशन कोफिशियंट. नाउ पुटिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ सी ईथर एंड सी वॉटर, दैट इज कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ ईथर दैट वी डिटर्मिंड अबव एंड कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉरी इफ आई बाई मिस्टेक प्रोनाउंस सम प्रोनाउंस लिटल बिट रॉन्गली आई एम करेक्टिंग इट. द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूट इन द ईथर एंड कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूट इन द वॉटर. सो कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सॉल्यूट इन ईथर आई टोल्ड यू इट इज x by 1000 and concentration of the solute in aqueous layer or concentration of the solute left unextracted in the aqueous layer is equal to a minus x divided by 1000. But as I told you that initially we assumed the partition coefficient of the solute in between organic or ether layer and water is equal to 2. So I can write x upon 1000 upon a minus x upon 1000 is equal to 2. So from here, if I wish to calculate x, then I can write from here 1000 upon 1000 will be cancelled out. So I will get rearranging this, after rearranging this, x would be equal to 2a minus 2x, and from here rearranging to get the terms of x on same side, I can write x plus 2x is equal to 2a, or I can write 3x is equal to 2a. So from here x comes out to be equal to 2 by 3a. So 2 by 3 here means 2/3, that is almost 0.67a, or 0.67a means almost 67%. So from here what I can say, I can say that if we use ether in single installment of 1000 ml, then only 67% of the substance is extracted. What is the meaning of this line? That if I was having, or assume, if I assume 100% of the solute initially, then by using 1000 ml of ether in single installment, then we can extract only 67% of the solute in single installment, and 33% remains in the aqueous solution. Is it clear? Now coming to the second case. Case 2 is, if we use ether in two installments of 500 ml each. अब मैं क्या करूँगा, यह क्या कर रहा हूँ मैं, कि जो ईथर है उसको एक इंस्टॉलमेंट में यूज़ करने की जगह 1000 ml की, मैं 500 ml की दो इंस्टॉलमेंट्स में यूज़ करूँगा. देन वट विल हैपन? सो फॉर दिस वट आई विल डू, लेट आई विल अज्यूम लेट x 1 grams ऑफ द सॉल्यूट आर एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम ईथर from water into ether layer using first installment of 500 ml. क्या कह रहा हूँ मैं कि जब मैंने ether को 1000 ml की installment में ना use करके 500 ml की दो installments में use करना चाह रहा हूँ, तो जब मैंने एक बार 500 ml की installment use की, तो हमने माना कि जो solute है वो water से ether में गया x 1 grams. Then the amount of substance left unextracted in aqueous layer will be given by how much? हमने initially x1 माना कि initially हमने capital A लिए थे, and x1 grams of the solute are extracted from water into ether.
So I can say that the amount of substance left unextracted in aqueous layer will be given by capital A minus x1 grams. Therefore, the concentration of the solute in ether layer will be equal to x1 upon 500. Why 500? Because x1 grams of the solute goes from aqueous layer into the ether layer, and we have used in this case only 500 ml of the ether. And the concentration of the solute in the water, now after using ether in one installment of 500 ml, we are left with capital A minus x1 grams of the solute in water layer. So the concentration of the solute in water will be equal to A minus x1 upon 1000. And we assumed in this case earlier that the partition coefficient of the substance in ether and water was equal to 2. So I can say that C ether upon C water is equal or equal to K is equal to 2. So by using these concentrations of solute in ether and water in the equation of partition coefficient, I can write x1 C ether is equal to concentration of the solute in ether is equal to x1 upon 500. This is concentration of ether in concentration of solute in ether is equal to x1 upon 500, and the concentration of substance left unextracted in water is equal to A capital A minus x1 upon 1000, and this comes out to be equal to 2. Why 2? Because partition coefficient we assumed in this case equal to 2. So from this 1000 can be divided by 500, so we will get 2 above, and rearranging this equation I will get 2x1 will be equal to 2 into capital A minus 2x1. So rearranging so as to get terms of x1 on one side, I will get 2x1 plus 2x1 is equal to 2a. So from here I can write 4x1 will be equal to 2a, and from here I can calculate x1 will be equal to 2 by 4 a, or 2 by 4 a means half. So x1 comes out to be equal to half of a, and half of a means 50%. So from this I can say that if we use ether in single installment of 500 ml, then only 50% of the solute or substance is extracted. What I am saying, if I use ether in 500 installment, then in the first installment 50% of the solute will be extracted from water into the ether layer. Now after extracting 50% of the solute from 1 liter of water, we are left with how much amount of the solute? Initially it was A, and if we extracted 50%, so now we are left with half of A. So we are left with half A grams of the solute. Now what we will do? We were having 1000 ml of ether, but in the first installment we used 500 ml. So now we are left with 500 ml more. So in the second installment I will use 500 ml of ether. Is it clear? In the next installment I will use the left amount of 500 ml ether. Then what will happen? Now let in the second extraction small x2 grams of the solute goes from aqueous layer into the 500 ml of ether. Then the concentration of the solute in the ether will be equal to, I used in the second installment ether equal to 500 ml, and amount that goes into the ether layer is equal to small x2. So concentration of solute in ether will be equal to how much? I am highlighting this. This would be equal to x2 by 500, and the amount of solute or concentration of the solute left in water will be equal to this much. How much it would be? The concentration of the solute will be equal to in water will be equal to, when we carried out first extraction we were left with half of A. So initial concentration for the second installment will be equal to half A. So concentration of the solute in left in water after second extraction will be equal to half A minus x2 divided by 1000, and the partition coefficient we assume to be equal to 2. So C ether upon C water is equal to 2 in this case, as you can see on the screen. This is C ether upon C water is equal to 2. So by putting the values of concentrations of solute in ether layer and that in water layer, concentration of ether concentration of solute in ether layer is equal to x2 by 500, and that in water is equal to half A minus x2 by 1000. So from here I can write x2 by 500 upon half A minus x2 upon 1000 will be equal to 2. So dividing 1000 by 500 I will get 2. So from here I will get 2x2 will be equal to A minus 2x2. So rearranging this equation so as to have terms of x2 on one side, I will get 2x2 plus 2x2 is equal to capital A. And from here I can write 4x2 will be equal to A. So x2 comes out to be equal to 1 by 4 of A, or A, I can say A by 4. So A by 4 means 1 fourth, or I can say 1 fourth here means equal to 25%, as you can see on the screen. So in the second installment of 500 ml of ether, we can extract only 25% of the substance. What I am saying that if we use ether in second installment of 500 ml, then we can extract 25% of the substance. So the total amount of substance extracted in two installments of 500 ml each would be equal to 75%. How? First installment mein humne kitna extract kiya? 50% 500 ml ki installment mein 50% substance extract hua, aur second mein 25 hua. So total is equal to 50 plus 25 is equal to 75. So from here I can say that if I use ether in two installments of 500 ml each, then we can extract total amount of the substance equal to 75%. However, if we used ether in single installment of 1000 ml, then the amount extracted was equal to 67%. Is it clear? So यहाँ से क्या पता चल रहा है? यहाँ से ये पता चल रहा है कि अगर हम ether को एक से ज़्यादा installment में use करेंगे तो जो substance extract होगा वो ज़्यादा extract होगा as compared to that in single installment. Similarly, if I use ether in four installments of 250 ml each, then you after calculation it would come out to be equal to 93.75. So by using ether in four installments we can extract 93.75% of the substance. So what you can conclude from here, that when we used ether, all of the ether in single installment, we can extract 67%. If I use ether in two installments of 500 ml each, then we can extract ether equal to 75%. And if I use ether in 4 installments of 250 ml each, then we can extract ether equal to 93.75%. So you can see with increase in the number of installments or lots, means if we are not doing extraction in a single step, we are doing it in large number of steps, then the more of the substance is extracted. So we can say that multi-step extraction is better as compared to single step extraction. What I can say that multi-step extraction is more efficient as compared to single step extraction, and this we have proved experimentally. Is it clear? So, but one point here to be noted is that we are doing large number of installments. So if we use large number of installments, then would it be possible for us to extract whole of the substance? My answer would be no. Why? Because if we use large number of installments, some of the amount will always remain in the solution. It is not possible to isolate the substance completely. So we can say that it is not possible to extract whole of the substance, howsoever large number of extractions we may carry out. What is the meaning of this line? Ki aham chahe kitni bhi extractions kar le, matlab kitni installments mein kar le, hum सब्सटांस को पूरा का पूरा नहीं निकाल सकते, चाहे थोड़ा ही बचेगा वो सॉल्यूशन में ज़रूर बचेगा. इज इट क्लियर? सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्शन. थैंक यू.